I remember when I first started listening to podcasts and I asked myself, how do you even make one? Well, Anchor. Anchor is it. Anchor is what is going to help you to become a successful podcaster that I know you want to be. It is super self-explanatory. It is super user-friendly. You get what you want. You want what you get. Even if you have a problem with it, emailing them and having any kind of questions about it, people will help you. The support is awesome. Anchor is it. If you don't have it, get it now and start your dreams of becoming the podcaster that you wish to be.
Welcome back to She Shoes.
Tell all.
Where we truly
tell it all.
And that is right. We are here to tell it all once again. And we couldn't be any more excited.
We are just thrilled. Our hearts are bursting with how excited we are.
Our hearts are bursting with joy, with gratitude, and with, go ahead.
Sexual energy. Why?
Yeah.
I couldn't even finish it. Nope.
No. Yeah.
Nope.
Definitely with sexual energy. How was your week? I'm honestly like not really in the mood right now. I'm going to be honest because I'm very transparent in this podcast. If there's anything that I'm, if there's anything that I am, it's transparent.
Like you are literally a fucking ghost. Like you're so transparent. I can't see you. Like right now, all I see is a floating hat and your headphones. That's all I see.
Someone even say I'm a glass house.
We must throw stones at glass houses.
Don't do it, mama.
My week is a little hectic, not to give any clout to Miss Corona, but you know, she is affecting my career. So, you know, I'm just, besides that stress, it's actually going really well.
What is she doing? Cause she's slowly trying to creep back.
She's not creeping. She's back. And she's like, hey girl, she's back.
And some of your students have, COVID.
The families, it's just affecting work. And it's just like she's dramatic and I hate her. But besides that, the weather, though a little humid, like the gloominess of it all just like got me thinking of Halloween, and I decided I'm gonna decorate on my birthday. It's Leo season, baby. So yeah, overall, I give the week like an 8 out of 10.
Well, that's good. You know, it's better than a 6 out of 10, I'll tell you that much.
Why was it why was it more 6 and maybe not like a 9 or even a 7
for myself?
Yeah.
Oh no, I don't even know. I can't even rate it. I'm just saying like it's better that you got an 8. I did hear something, speaking of Cordova, that the Abbey in West Hollywood, in order to go in there, it's like you have to in order to get in, you have to prove that you just took a test in the last 48 hours or that you're vaccinated, otherwise you can't get in.
I feel like a lot more places are going to start doing that.
Mm-hmm. And there's this Instagram account that I follow called Hillcrest San Diego. And they're like, oh, look what our sisters are doing, like talking about LA. And they're like, watch out, San Diego. Because every time anything happens in Los Angeles, you automatically, us that live in San Diego, we're just like, oh, fuck, we're always
going to trickle down. It's going to trickle down to us. And so whatever she's doing, we get the after effects. Mask mandates are back here in the city of Chula Vista. In any city building, you have to wear a mask regardless if you're vaccinated or not. Restaurants are starting to do it again, and it's just not a fucking vibe.
So even in Chula Vista, when you're going into like grocery stores, you have to wear your mask?
No, just city buildings. So like the library, the police station.
Mm. Oh yeah, because courts. I'm always at the police station.
Always. You bad girl.
Like you can't get me out of there. You know what I mean? Like the police station, that's where I am. Like if they're like, hey, where's sir? I haven't seen him in a while. Oh, well, he's at the police station.
He even has his lunch there.
A lunchable. Well, without further ado, I know that you guys are very excited to hear us talk about Cordova because, you know, it's such a great topic. We're not going to do it.
We said I wasn't going to give that bitch clout and she got like 3 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Enough. Well,
enough. In the words of Taylor Armstrong, enough. Well, without further ado, let's get into it.
talented, brilliant, incredible, amazing, show-stopping, spectacular, never the same, totally unique, completely not ever been done before, unafraid to reference or not reference, put it in a blender, shit on it, vomit on it, eat it, give birth to it.
And that's right. It's time for Bo and Elsie. And this week, we're starting off with our Bo. Our Bo this week is, I'm going to give it to someone very simple, someone that's well deserved for it. And it's Jeff Epstein. And you might be thinking, like, the perv? No.
No.
No, 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 no. Not the perv. Jeff Epstein is probably more known as a meme queen, if you will. He used to have a podcast called Pop Goggles, and then it turned into Manic, but then his podcast wasn't where it wanted it to be, a la STA.
True words have never been spoken.
So he was like, you know what? I'm not going to do this until I'm picked up by a network, which I'm thinking like maybe Dear Media should pick him up, because I feel like, is Dear Media the Skinny Confidential?
Yeah. So her and her husband own Dear Media and then all those podcasts there. Yeah.
So I feel like, why don't they pick him up? Because I think that Alexis Nyers has a podcast with Dear Media.
She does. Uh-huh.
And Alexis Nyers and Jeff Epstein are really good friends.
They are. And then Jackie Schimmel's also on that network. And I just feel it's like that same vibe.
Mm-hmm.
It just makes sense.
If you follow him on Instagram, his Instagram is called It's Jeff Epstein. And he goes through a lot of troubles and tribulations because people always assume that, you know, imagine your name being Jeff Epstein in this climate. And you know that people message him saying like, haha, you're so funny trying to call yourself Jeff Epstein. Like, I don't get the joke. You know, he's always getting like those kind of messages.
And people like every now and then he'll post like something like an ID card. Like, dude, this is literally my fucking name.
Yeah. He gets bashed all the time thinking that he's being funny by giving himself that name. But, you know, he's a Jewish boy. And I feel like the last name Epstein is really common in Jewish households.
Yeah, right? any Steen, that's usually a Jewish last name. I even have reposted some of his posts, and people have been like, huh, funny handle. I'm like, dude, that's literally his name.
Yeah, he posts a lot of Bravo stuff and a lot of old Bravo. He's more into old Bravo housewives, like the early New York or early Bev Hills. And yes, I did just say Bev Hills. So I kind of relate to it because I feel like I like the old housewife stuff as well. I also love his music. His taste in music is immaculate. It's exactly something that you would probably take out of my CD player. And yes, I did say CD player because it's just stuff from the early 2000s. And I've messaged him about it and we've had conversations about it. And it's like, because he also likes to interact back. So
he always responds. Yeah.
And he's always in San Diego as well because his sister lives in Mission Valley. So you can always catch him at your local Hooters or possibly Pho on Fifth.
Also, the JCPenney at Fashion Valley Mall.
I'm sure he goes there because he also loves a bargain. And I feel like JCPenney's all about bargains, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a very señora store, but it's definitely fitting for him for his Nike t-shirts. And
yeah, you won't get him out of a Nike t-shirt. He loves to wear Nike t-shirts. He loves to play a good The Academy Is. And he loves cars. I don't really know much about cars. All I really know about cars is that you have to drive them, you have to wash them eventually, and put gas here and there. Other than that, don't ask me anything else because I really could give a shit. It's really what the kind of person that I am. And I'm here to be honest because I am what? Transparent.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
And I also have to say one more thing about him. Oh, he's a twin. He's a Gaylord Focker.
His family is funny.
His family loves to party. Imagine he's a good time. Oh, yeah. He's been to jail like 10 times, I think.
Yeah. Did you do that? Remember when he was trying to see what's the best mugshot? I was voting on that.
Yeah, I was voting too. Because he used to steal stuff and do drugs, and he was very much into heroin. And now he's clean, and now he's just like chucking and thriving.
He's just funny. He's like raw and real, just like STA. And so we appreciate it.
And he's good looking. He's a good looking guy.
Yeah. But as you would say, Odrasir, I don't have what he needs.
No. You know, but you can be his sister gear. And that's why Jeff Epstein, check him out on Instagram. That's why he is my beau. And it's time for the LC. Clip, clip, clip.
This week's LC is long overdue, but I felt that it was time to give the LC to none other than Shitstain Pierce Morgan.
Yeah.
As you know, Simone Biles is out of the Olympics by choice, and it's none of our fucking business, and I support her forever. But of course, Pierce Morgan had something to say about a woman's decision. He tweeted, "Are mental health issues now the go-to excuse for any poor performance in elite sport? What a joke. Just admit you did badly, made mistakes, and will strive to do better next time. Kids need strong role models, not this nonsense." Then, of course, people responded. Someone said, "What is it with you and strong Black women?" He said, "I love strong Black women. What it is with you bringing..." Oh, what it is... He can't
What is write. It?
What it is with you bringing race into this debate. Maybe it's a British thing, but instead of "what is it," he said "what it is." Anyway.
What's up?
Give me your number.
And I'll call and follow that ass in the mall.
Dude, they are never going to make music like they did when we were in middle school and high school. Elementary school as well. Side note, because I really don't give a fuck about Pierce Morgan. He's a piece of shit. There is a playlist on Spotify called Millennial Trash, and it is chef's kiss.
Send it over.
So he's literally a piece of shit ranting about Simone Biles' choice to step away from the Olympics. I just don't understand why he thinks that he should have any opinion in this matter. And it's enough. He seriously has.
In the words of Taylor Armstrong, enough.
He just always goes after people, specifically women. He has gone after Chrissy Teigen, even though we don't really like support her anymore. At the time, like, he was just out of line. He's disgusting.
Let's not go too far. The Meghan Markle of it all.
How could I forget the Meghan Markle of it all? Oh my God, he's just trash. And I think it's time for him to just go. He's got to go.
This is the thing about Pierce Morgan. I think that his takes, I don't know if he does it purposely to try to have hot takes on things. But if you ever feel yourself being on the side of Pierce Morgan, just know that you're on the wrong side of history.
Yeah,
I can't imagine anyone ever agreeing with him of what he says. And I don't know if he does it for cheap attention. As we know, he had a lot of cheap beef with Meghan Markle a couple months ago. He even walked out of Good Morning Britain. I think he even quit on the spot because people were questioning him while he was attacking her.
Yeah, he quit on the spot. He really did.
And we all think that he probably had a cheap crush on her and something went wrong. I don't know. He loves to attack women. He loves, not really attack women, but like talk for them. And like
mansplain.
And it's just like, no. Like I said, if you ever feel yourself agreeing or sitting in the same corner as Pierce Morgan.
Pierce Morgan.
Just know that you're on the wrong side and you need to check yourself. Yes, before you wreck yourself. Oh my God, that was so trashy. I'm so sorry. Can we rewind that and pretend I never said that?
It's okay. Now we're par for the course because I was awful right in the beginning. Because
what did you say about sexual?
Yeah. So anyway, Pierce Morgan is a lost fucking cause that will never be redeemed. I can guarantee.
No, that will never be redeemed because I don't think he cares to be redeemed. I think he likes this lifestyle of his.
I think so too.
Which is being hated. Imagine how many like tweets he gets of people attacking him. If I get tweets a day, people attacking me. Imagine him.
It's just his mailbox is full.
Yep. So before we move on, I want to kind of talk about a little bit about Broadway. What do you reckon? Because I did start listening to a new podcast this week.
Ooh. Que perra, que perra, que perra, mi amiga.
Que perra, que perra, que perra, mi amiga. Okay. So it's a very interesting podcast, actually. Oh, and before I tell you the podcast that I started listening to this week, I did part ways with some.
Okay.
I did part ways. Okay. Are you guys ready?
That's huge.
Yeah, it's huge. Like deleted them, no longer following them. They're no longer, because I don't know if you guys seen on the podcast platform for Apple. It's like you can like, it's just different. It's like, I like the new way that how they fix it now where you can just download and follow them, you know?
Yes.
Also follow STA, subscribe, rate, and of course review. parted ways with Call Her Daddy.
Oh, what? I was not expecting that.
Nope, I knew no one was, because everyone knows I mean Alex Cooper.
Your like sister this. Soulmates. Why? What happened?
There's no longer no new episodes on Apple Music. I have to go to Spotify, and I just want all my podcasts to be in one platform.
Yeah, that happened with last podcast on the left, and I was like, ew.
Mm-hmm. There's, yeah. It's still there, but it's all the way up to like July something. Yes. So there's nothing new. So.
And you just can't do it.
No, can't do it. I still like her, still support her, still follow her. Go listen to her on Spotify. Nothing wrong with her. Just couldn't do it. And she had to leave. Sorry, Koopa. And I also parted ways with comments by celebs.
Oh. Why them? Because they're obnoxious?
You think they're obnoxious?
I don't know. I just couldn't listen. I love their Instagram account.
Yeah, it's informative.
But I just couldn't. I listened to a few of their episodes, and I don't know. It just wasn't for me. Because I love pop culture, but they just couldn't deliver it the way I needed.
No, that's why I left. I completely understand what you're saying. I feel like the way they inform me of pop culture, it's too serious. Do you know what I mean? It became too like, and we're going to give you this. And sometimes I just want like to be like a little bit of like enough by Taylor Armstrong in the podcast, you know, and they don't have any like quirky side.
And I feel like they don't like know when to stop.
No. And they love everything. They're never negative. And I need some negativity in the podcast. Like if you're not going to give me something negative, I can't deal with just positiveness, you know?
You know what it is? I think because so many celebrities follow their account, they don't want to piss any celebrities off. So then it's just boring.
And it's also very Kardashian heavy. Mm-hmm. They have a Kardashian segment on the podcast. So I'm just like, what? Like, stop. And I was like, why am I listening to something I'm just being forced to, you know? So therefore I had room, and I haven't added this podcast yet, but it was so interesting for me, like listening to him, Jason Tartik, Trading Secrets.
I didn't know he had a podcast.
No. And guess what? Dear Media.
Actually, they're pretty good friends with Jason.
I figured. And if you don't know who Jason Tartik is, he was on the Bachelorette Becca season.
Yes. And I actually, I misspoke when you brought that up. I don't remember if it was last episode or episode before. And I was like, no. I'm like, duh, yes. After the fact, I was like, I'm an idiot. Yes, he was on Becca season.
Oh, yeah.
He was on Becca season. You're right.
And he's engaged. Engagement. Marriage.
Babies.
He's engaged with Caitlin Bristow. Yep. Woo! Good old Caitlin. So his podcast is so informative. He gets people, Claudia Osher. I was into Claudia Osher's episode. She was on it. Elena from Big Brother was on it. He gets people, influencers, people from reality TVs, just reality TV and influencers. And they talk everything about money, how much they make with a post, how much they make on the show, how much they make, like it's all money.
I always wonder like how much did they get paid for that post? And oh, like what influencer makes way more than the other ones, even though you wouldn't think.
Depending on your following. Like I was listening to Elena's, and she told us everything about Big Brother, about X on the Beach. On Big Brother, you make $1,000 a week. And that's why some people want to stay there longer, because some people want to, they quit their jobs to come on here. And you're like, no, I don't want to leave yet. And I want to at least make it to jury, because after you make it to jury, you're still getting paid weekly $1,000, even though you're not on TV on all the episodes, but you're still, you know, and sequestered with the show. So like the first five people who leave without jury, their $1,000 just ends after that.
Fuck, that sucks. I'd be pissed.
Yep. So Travis, Frenchie, and Brent, their $1,000 just stopped. And then after that, like she talked about X on the Beach, and then Claudia talked about her, just the post that she makes, and like how reality TV, just the contracting of it all, like just Trading Secrets. That's what it's about. Reality television.
Oh my gosh. I always wondered at what point does someone who's on like a friend of on reality TV or pops up here and there, like at what point do they start getting paid? Like, cause it's one thing like, well, you're invited to my party and there happen to be filming, or we're going to mic you up and you're going to have some scenes. Like at what point do they start making money, even if they're just friends?
Yeah. I think it'd be so interesting if you brought over someone from Bravo or like a housewife, but it has to be someone who's not contracted. Like, I don't think Jason Tartik has any like contracts with The Bachelor anymore, right? He has nothing to do with her anymore, so he can easily say this.
Yeah, Elena, you can talk about it.
Elena has no contracts with Big Brother anymore, so she can easily say it.
It would need to be like a
Danielle Staub.
Yes, she'll say everything.
She'll say everything. Yeah. But it's really interesting. It's a really interesting podcast. Like, you learn so much.
I want to listen because I want these answers.
There he is, Jason Chartier.
Oh, he's so cute.
Trading Secrets. Check it out.
Wow. You know what? I shit so much on Podrec, but this one
was informative.
Very
informative, yet shocking. Yet it threw a curveball. You guys didn't know that I would ever part ways.
Whoa. Whoa.
You guys didn't know that I would ever part ways with Alex Kupa.
Mm-mm. Actually, you know what? I thought of you the other day when I was listening to You Up, the podcast You Up, because they had an ad for Sophia with an F. And I was like, ooh, that girl.
You're like, who's that girl? Who's that? Okay. Let's get into it. Big Brother. Big Brother. What a week. But I do have a lot of thoughts about Big Brother that I'm kind of annoyed.
Oh, okay.
Well, for starters, Brent's gone. What were your thoughts on Brent leaving?
It was about, like, literally everyone in the house was like, this cannot come quick enough. Like, it wasn't even a question. Everyone was going to vote Brent out. And he was just so delusional that it made it funny because they made their decision. Like, as soon as the two were put up, they're like, all right, obviously everyone's voting Brent out. And it was just kind of funny seeing him like, oh, yeah. What's the new alliance name?
The Mafia.
The Mafia. And everyone's like, yeah. And like, no, this isn't. It was just so funny because he's such an idiot. And as much as like I said, 10 out of 10 would sit on his face. Like, oh, God, he was obnoxious.
Like, Brent was leaving, was going home before Frenchie was even gone. They were already talking about getting rid of him last week.
Like, yeah, Frenchie just happened to stay on longer than planned, but he was like already like, boom.
How did he really not catch the vibe that no one liked him and no one took him seriously?
I think everyone just did a really good job at faking it.
I guess they did.
Or he's probably very delusional too. He's so in his ego. Mm-hmm.
He's so into himself. He says that he's never had a girl/friend.
I didn't know that. I didn't catch that.
He says that he can't have girlfriends. That's not normal. That's not normal. But he'll only have a girlfriend if he's interested in fucking them. Otherwise, he wouldn't. He was having that conversation with Whitney and Hannah, and Whitney and Hannah could not look any more like.
Oh, you know what? I think so. I had to do some work stuff real quick, and I kept it on. Maybe that was. So I was like, oh, whatever. I know he's leaving, so I wasn't paying attention.
But you know, some of the sometimes I was like, dude, you have to understand what's going on. Like when he accidentally he walked up to Hannah and Derek X having a conversation.
Oh, when they were outside, like, it was so obvious.
And then he's like, so what about HOH next week? And then Derek X is like, oh yeah, like I think I'm just gonna throw it to you if you know for HOH. And he's like, yeah. And then Hannah's like, yeah, totally. I was like, how is he not realizing that they're
because he's so like, oh yeah, it's his fucking ego. It's like, yeah, they all fucking love me.
It's such a shame because he's so hot.
So hot
that he has to act like this. Like,
and at first he wasn't giving that off, but mm-mm. Then like I feel like the longer you're there, all your personality starts to come out and people are like, oh
yeah. I think that he was just like, and he like none of the girls were into him. Like Whitney hated him.
Yeah, I know. And Whitney was so good at like fronting because like for a while I thought she was.
It's because this really shows you how sometimes really looks aren't all. Looks aren't everything at all. You know, you can be as hot as you want, and if you can't carry yourself, you will not get. He had nothing. Like no girl even wanted. They were like, ugh. He was such a turnoff to girls. Yeah. You know,
and that definitely also comes with like maturity when you're just like, yeah, you're hot, but it's not fucking worth it.
I sent you a picture of him last night. Did you do like a little deep dive on his Instagram?
I didn't because I saw it real quick in the morning.
You check out his Instagram. It's everything you expect it to be.
Okay.
Just whatever you're expecting, what you're gonna see, that's what his Instagram is.
Okay.
Like I travel, I've gone all over the world. The reason why I'm disappointed is because I do not like Alyssa and Christian. They're annoying me. They're thinking they're running the house, and this whole season we've kind of seen I'm not getting shocked. We already know. We know every week who's going home, you know. Like we knew Travis was leaving. Like, well, we didn't know Travis was leaving right away because he wasn't on the block right away. So maybe that first week was kind of like, oh, okay. But then as soon as Frenchie was put on the block, we knew he was leaving. Last week, as soon as Brent was put on the block, we knew that he was leaving. And I feel like we already know what Chris and Alyssa want to do. They talked about it. They're going to put up Whitney. They're going to put up Hannah. And I bet you Whitney's going to end up leaving. It's so predictable now.
Yeah.
And I like being surprised. I was actually rooting for your girl, Brittany, to win. I wanted Brittany, Derek F, and Azza to win because I feel like they'll shake things up and do something different.
I was going to say everyone's so safe right now that it's just like, oh yeah, let's all agree to vote up Frenchie. Okay. We're all going to agree to vote up Brent. Like it's nothing. Like I feel like other seasons have been divided from the get go.
Yeah.
So it made it like, well, we're going to put up, you know, I don't know. I see what you mean. It's very just like agreeable.
When Christian won this HOH, I was like,
I wrote HOH was stressful as fuck. I did not like that game, but I put ill Christian.
Yeah. Because we know we heard what he's going to do. He's going to want to, because he wants Whitney gone. Which yeah. I don't understand why.
I don't mind Whitney, actually.
Yeah. So I hope Whitney can. And also, this Sunday is going to be the last. I forgot that competition they have that does a twist.
Oh, my gosh. Why was I going to say Paige Turner?
Well, it's just a twist that they have. I don't know. Oh, you can pay me right now. You could be like, hey, you know, we're going to give you $1 million if you name me that comp. I'd lose. No. Like,
nope.
It sucks so bad.
Bye. Goodbye, $1 million.
And it sucks. Like, I would lose $1 million just because I can't remember that. But it's all part of our dementia because we both have dementia.
We truly do.
In the words of Taylor Armstrong, enough.
I just wanted to say that I added Hannah to my top three.
Oh, yeah. Me too.
So I have Big D, Hannah, and Derek X.
I have Hannah. Did I have Hannah? Yeah. Kylan. And I had Xavier, but I just don't like his group.
Yeah, I took out Kylan for Hannah just because I feel like we didn't really get to see him this week, so I don't know what he's up to.
It'll probably change back, huh?
Yeah, and then I kept the Derek's for now.
You know, Xavier, I think he's such a nice guy.
Yeah, but it's so funny how Big D just like figured out he was a lawyer. Yeah,
he's like, shut up.
Like, girl, you a witch. Like, he knew.
It's because Xavier, he's like so put together, you know. Very he knows how to say something. Yeah. Like he just knows how to like convince you. Like he could even be a sales rep.
Yeah.
I would like buy something from him. Like, yeah, you're right. Like, and he just means well. Like I like when he was upstairs crying because he saw Brittany cry.
He felt so bad. Yeah, I felt so bad. And also, like, I feel like I really related to Asa because you're just such empaths that she was like, dude, I get it, it's a game, but also this girl is fucking hurt.
She takes it really. This game is not for Brittany. It's too much for her.
No. And
really
I didn't like. I didn't like that Tiffany was like, she's too in her feelings. It's like, it's not that, dude. Like Brittany has autism, and she's just not gonna process this the same way as everyone else. Like that.
I feel like it's not really talked about. I feel like we talked about it on her intro when she was first going into the house, but it's never talked about or mentioned again. Like no one on Twitter mentions it. They just hate on her. They say that on the live. I don't really watch the live feeds because it gets me too much spoilers, but they say that she's insufferable on the live feed, that she lies about things, that she goes and tells somebody one thing and goes and tells someone another thing, which they're not putting it on the live episode, on the episodes. So I'm not sure her behavior on the live feeds, what she's doing to cause people to really, really bash her.
I feel like if it was something really huge, wouldn't we know?
We would see it right on the episode. I don't know what's going on, but it's mainly the live feeds where the audience is not relating to her and they do not like her. They don't like Derek F either. They don't like
Brent. Why? Because why don't they like Derek F?
Because it seems like because we're just going by what we see on the episodes. That's true. So that's true. I don't know what they do. And obviously the episodes are very edited to what the producers want us to, you know, the character development.
But I'm not gonna sit there and watch live feeds.
No, it's too much. And then we watch the live feeds, there'd be no point of us watching the episodes because we would know everything. We would know who won the veto. We would know, you know.
But I understand because when I used to watch Big Brother VIP from Mexico, I was so giddy that we went to Ensenada for a few days. So I got to watch the live feeds on Sky.
My dad had Sky.
Because over there in Mexico, they would stream the live feeds on TV. So you didn't have to like go online. You could watch it on your TV. And I was just like glued to the TV.
Well, the live feeds aren't online. They're on Paramount Plus.
Oh, but you know what I mean? Like you need, like, this was just like, you turn the channel on and it's there.
No, I know, because my dad had Sky. We had Sky at our house. Do you remember?
I don't know. I don't.
Or maybe it was Marifer. We, they, Yeah, I think my dad came over and I thought it was, I think you were there too.
I probably was, honestly.
This show was on Big Brother on the four little dots back there. And you guys were like, is that Big Brother? How do you have this?
Oh my gosh. See, even then I was jealous because we would watch Big Brother in Mexico and it was so good.
Because my dad was obsessed with soccer, Mexican soccer. Same. So that, and they had like the latest games were on Sky. So he got Sky and we just had it in the downstairs living room and we would just leave it on. If you ask my brother, we knew we grew up with it just being, maybe that's why I'm such a Big Brother stan.
Could be.
Yeah. What were we talking about? Let's go back to the US Big Brother. So basically I feel like it's predictable and I feel like that Whitney is going to be on the block alongside with Hannah. That's unless if they don't get a special power. Aaron. So I think that unless they get a special power in the Sunday's episode, which I hope Whitney does and things change. Because if Whitney leaves this week, I'm gonna be so upset just because who do you think you are, Alyssa? And Christian is so ugly. Do you think he's cute?
No.
Thank you. No one does. But like what does Alyssa see? Okay, who cares? Whatever.
She said his lips are so soft. I was like, ew, I don't care. His hair and his glasses and his, I just don't like anything about him. His personality, dude.
Nothing. Zero. Not one. So there you have it. Looking forward to see what happens next, but at the same time, scared that it's going to be predictable as fuck. We do not have Bachelorette this week. We're taking a little break because we need to take a break for our mental health. Although Wells did give me some spoilers. Did you hear who went home?
I did because they talked about it on Sorry, We're Stoned. And I'm not surprised.
He went home on his own. He
said, I'm not surprised.
Enough!
He said, my kid thinks I don't want him anymore. Bye.
And so that means we're talking about Michael, everyone. Michael went home on his own right before hometowns. He missed his kid. He didn't want to do it anymore. And he dipped. So there's only a final three, which is Justin, Blake, and Greg. And, you know, since me and Tanya kind of established that we weren't going to do Bachelorette this week just because time, I haven't watched it yet. When I don't have that pressure that we're going to recap it, I'll watch it eventually.
Because I know that he left, and then I know that Jason proposed to
Caitlin.
So that's basically all that happened.
AKA Jason Tartik, who we were just talking about. What a full circle. Yeah.
And then just on Sorry, We're Stoned, they were just saying like, oh, Tayshia's so good at hosting. Like, this should be her job. She should just take over as the host of Bachelor Nation.
Yeah.
And I agree.
And Sorry, We're Stoned is Miley Cyrus's mom and Miley Cyrus's sister. Right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Sorry, I assumed everyone knows. Like, literally, probably no one knows.
And Brandi Cyrus is also on the podcast that I listen to with Wells.
Oh, yes.
Circle. So I always hear about Brandy's stories, how she's a DJ and how she loves riding her horses. And, you know, that's neither here nor there. So since there's no batch this week, let's do Jam Stan. What jam do you stan? And we had local natives. And I said no. Right?
You said enough.
I said, in the words of Taylor Armstrong, enough. Because I wasn't enjoying them. I was just driving around and listening to them, and on a stoplight, I was like, stop. And I don't know why.
It's just, you just weren't having it. Sometimes it's just not what you need.
Because I'm at the moment not like other girls.
So local natives, you're just gonna like take a break. Maybe we'll get back to you. Put out some new music. How about that?
Mabes. So we're giving it to Lord. Yes, that's right. Lord. And no, not Lord Farquaad. Lord Ella Maria Lenny Yelich O'Connor. She's known professionally as Lord.
O'Connor.
And, she's a New Zealand singer-songwriter. And she was back in the day like one of those girls that you just knew who it was. Like, oh, Lord. Of course, who didn't listen to Royals? Okay, I'm not gonna hum it because I know. She was kind of what Billie Eilish is. Do you agree?
Yes.
Very Billie Eilish adjacent. She was very young. She was just out there, like, chucking and thriving, like, on the coasts of Taylor Swift. They were sisters, just making songs very different, very, like, a very edgy, very, like,
edgy. That's what it is.
Indie edgy. And even her, the way she would dress, like her outfits, it was like, Lord, is that girl? But all of a sudden, she disappeared. We're like, where the fuck's Lord?
Whoa, Lord. Where'd she go?
Where's Lord?
Where's Lord?
She just came back recently and she has two new songs. And one of them is very relatable, obviously, because it's called Stone at the Nail Salon. And Tanya, have you ever been stoned at the nail salon?
Yeah, all the time. Literally 2 weeks ago and probably tomorrow morning because I need a fill.
Like, if you're not stoned at the nail salon, what are you doing at the nail salon?
Then where the fuck you at?
I hate that girl. Me too. If you're not, you're at the river, then where the fuck you at? I'm at work because I don't have a job. Claudia Ostre did one, and she's like, if you're not on the couch watching reality TV, where the fuck you're at?
Actually, that's exactly where I'm at. Thanks, Claudia.
Yeah, I agreed with her. I was like, yeah, Claudia, you're right.
So,
back to Lord. Stone at the Nail Salon. Let's just listen to it and let me know what you think.
I'm a dog who comes when I call, but I wonder sometimes what I'm missing. Well, my heart has been burning for so many summers now. It's time to cool it down, wherever that leads. 'Cause all the beautiful girls, they will fade like the roses. And all the times they will change, it'll all come around. I don't know. Maybe I stoned at the nail salon. Maybe I
and that's right, Lord. We're all stoned at the nail salon.
I know you were vibing out with your eyes closed, but I just was going for it.
You were giving me like a rendition of Northwest at Kanye West's church. What was his concerts called?
Sunday service.
You were giving me a Northwest Sunday service rendition. I felt your Nordy vibes. Nordy's Black Book.
I am so glad that that's what came off. Because if you don't know, Nori is like the show at Sunday service. Like, yeah, everyone goes, ah, Sunday service. But then Nori comes out and it's done.
Yeah. She is the moment.
I really enjoy that song.
Well, it's very like, I mean, it's called Stone at the Nail Salon.
Like, how much more relatable can you get to that?
For the love of Pete, like, we don't really have to, like, elaborate it more, you know? Like, come on! So go check out Lord. Her other song that she has is called Solar Power. And I feel like it was time to give a woman jam stand. We haven't given to a woman in a while. And what better than to Lord? I'm not sure if she's coming out with an EP or this is just, like she's like, she's dipping her toes in to see what we're all about in 2021.
I would love an EP. Maybe not a full album, but like four songs.
What about a collab with Lord and Billie Eilish?
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
Well, Billie Eilish is coming out with a new album soon. Remember, she even had a new look?
Yeah, we talked about it on mm-hmm. Tanya's Tea.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of Tanya's Tea, what's the tea?
Well, House of Gucci trailer is out and the girls are dying because Gaga is the 80s.
So good.
It is so good. Adam Driver, fucking daddy. And I don't use that word often.
Daddy?
I don't. Because
daddy,
I feel
you're a
like,
crook. Where's that from?
Matilda. I had to think about it for a second. I fell in love with him watching Star Wars. But
it's okay. Don't be ashamed of your Star Wars backer because if you're not liking Chewbacca, tell them what shirt I'm wearing.
Chewbacca. No. fucking turkey and not Chewbacca.
Yeah, that was like a turkey. Let me do Chewbacca. That was Kiko from El Chavo, actually.
Oh my God, why are you bringing up more situationships of mine? Remember, there was a situationship with Kiko?
Oh yeah, you did have a Kiko.
I was like, oh, I'm going to give this guy a chance. And I showed you a picture and you're like, he looks like Kiko. And it was done.
And if you don't know who Kiko is, go to Google and go on Google and Google Kiko El Chavo. You'll know it right there and then.
As soon as you said that, I was completely disgusted and just basically ghosted him.
Mm-hmm. But back to House of Gooch. Gooch.
I'm Gooch.
We're Gooch. We're Gooch.
Oh yeah, we're Gooch.
We're Gooch.
We're Gooch. We're Gooch. Quail. We're Gooch.
We're Gooch.
Yeah, this is like so fucking good. The fashion, I am.
Fashion.
And aside, like we all know now, Gaga's like a good actress. We've mm-hmm. got Jared Leto looking unrecognizable. He plays
Jared Leto. He's always so captivating. Yeah,
we've talked about it on here before that he just like transforms into these characters. So he plays the cousin of Maurizio Gucci. Al Pacino's in it. Salma Hayek's in it.
Tom Ford.
It just looks so fucking good. And this one, oh God, I'm usually like, you know, like we love movies, but this one I am just like, it's art, the fashion, and just gonna be like.
And Lady Gaga is just, we knew this was going to be on a different level since the moment they started filming it. We knew this. Like mm-hmm. when we were seeing Lady Gaga's looks, and that's why she couldn't make it to a lot of things. And when she was filming over there, we were like, dude, this is going to be so good. Like Lady Gaga can bring it. She really, really can.
Mm-hmm.
She's
just so talented.
And everything this she touches, right?
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. Just looking forward to it. And as more trailers come out, as more things, information about the movie, we'll keep updating until it's released.
It comes out in November.
Yeah. But I
swear. House of Gooch.
Next up there, you know, we haven't had festivals, concerts. We have Lollapalooza going on right now. And Snoop Dogg made an announcement a few days ago about a different festival called Lovers and Friends.
Lovers and Friends. That's an Usher song, right?
So this is going to be in Las Vegas on May 14th, 2022.
Oh, girl, we have
a I'm going to read you the whole fucking lineup, okay? Because this
Do you want to give me away. Do you want to give me Stan or Ban?
For the whole lineup, it's like mm-hmm. 40 people.
Okay, no.
Let me do the biggest, the ones, the names that are the biggest, and then we'll go through the rest. Usher.
Ban.
Okay. Ludacris.
Oh, Stan.
Lil Jon.
Ban.
Miss Lauryn Hill.
Stan.
TLC.
Stan.
Ciara.
Stan.
Nelly.
Stan.
Ashanti and Ja Rule.
Stan.
Trey Songz.
Ban.
Neo.
Because I'm so sick of love songs. So, Stan.
Brandy and Monica.
Ooh, Stan.
Timberland.
I can do without, man.
Akon.
Lonely. I'm so lonely. It reminds me of when I crashed outside of your house. for PTSD version, for PTSD reasons, ban.
T-Pain.
Oh, Justice for T-Pain, ban. Stan.
Because of the auto-tune of it all.
Yeah.
Lil Kim.
Stan, she'll give you a good show.
Sean DePaul.
Sean Paul. Not give me the ring. Nah, 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 nah. Stan.
Fuck it, I'm going through all of these. I'm going to go fast. Fabulous.
Ban.
Eve.
Stan.
The Dream.
Ooh, ban.
Genuine.
Ben.
Escape.
Is that with Candy?
Yes.
Ooh, Stan, just because it's Candy.
Jodeci.
Ban.
Keith Sweat.
Ban.
Mace.
Stan.
Fat Joe.
Ban.
Cassie.
Ooh, I love Cassie. Stan.
Twista.
Ban.
Maya.
Stan.
Cameron.
Ban.
SWV.
Stan. I saw
them. Sean Kingston.
Oh, Sean Kingston. Oh, go away to beautiful girl. Stan.
Trick Daddy.
Trick Daddy said, Trick Daddy's very controversial. I'm going to ban. Did you see him on Love and Hip Hop?
No. Anyway. Pretty Ricky, Ricky, Ricky.
Oh, Pretty Ricky. I'm going to have to stamp because I had a special connection with him.
Joe.
Ban.
Drew Hill.
Ban.
Next.
Ban.
112.
No, I'll give next a stand. I give 112 a stand as well.
Okay. Mario.
I have a, I love that song from Mario. So stan.
Donnell Jones.
Ban.
Got a few more. Foxy Brown.
Stan, because she's one of the oldest rap female rappers in the game.
Trina.
Oh, stan.
Tweet.
Ban.
A. Marie.
Ban.
Khalees.
Oh, stan.
Okay, a few more. Stay with me. Juvenile.
Stan.
Too Short.
Stan.
Ying Yang Twins.
Stan.
Mike Jones.
Ooh, Mike Jones. Ooh, Mike Jones. Stan.
Lloyd.
Stan.
John B.
Ban.
Kevin Little.
Ban.
Baby Bash.
Bam.
Frankie J.
Ban.
And last, Nina Sky.
Nina Sky.
Yeah, you might girl make the fellas go.
She performed the for Nathan's girl. Birthday, and Nathan signed her a, or she signed Nathan a signature with her poster on it. And Nathan's like, I don't fucking want this, and threw it because he was drunk. He was belligerent. It was his 21st birthday.
Oh my god.
So since Nathan did that to her, I'm gonna have to stand Nina Sky.
So that is all in one fucking day. Like, I didn't even know it was like, I wasn't believing that it was real.
This
is crazy.
Well, I think that this looks epic.
Yeah, it literally is. Yeah.
How much are tickets?
They start at $20.
What?
Oh no, sorry. $20 down. Like, you have to put a deposit of $20.
Yeah, I'm sure this is probably really expensive. It's probably going to be such a big show, especially by May 2022. I don't want to talk about Cornova this way. No, I really
this is going to happen. Yeah,
because this bitch is like always trying to like try us, but I think this is going to be a good spot, and I'm here for it, especially in Las Vegas.
Yeah,
it's just so many people, I'm kind of overwhelmed.
I know, and hopefully they stream it live on YouTube.
Is it going to be like a Warped Tour situation?
Literally, yes, it is. It has to be, because there's no way they can all share one stage. It's too much.
Yeah. Well, what is this event called?
Lovers and Friends.
Lovers and Friends. Wah-wah-wah-wah-wah. I'm excited for it.
Me too. And I feel like it's going to give us really good content.
Yeah. I think I might even go.
I would love to go, but I know myself, and that's a long ass day in Vegas in the sun. So I just don't think it would be for me, but it probably I would.
For you.
For me, be in Vegas at that time, because you know, like all the bars and stuff are going to have like 80s, 90s, early 2000s hip hop and R&B. So that would be fun.
You can be at the Bellagio.
I love the Bellagio.
Because you're going to the Bellagio. Where the fuck you at?
I'm at the Luxor because I'm broke.
Also, before you hop on to the next story, I wanted to apologize to the listeners and to you as well, because last week I promised that I would do a Stan Band MTV's Cribs edition with you. And yesterday I was trying to look for the whole list of the people and I couldn't find it. And I was looking for about a good 6 minutes and I got to Cespedes and I stopped looking.
Yeah, so, that's enough.
Yeah. I was like, where's the fucking list? But it was just the same people that we spoke. JoJo Siwak, Caitlyn Jenner, Snooki, Ashley Simpson and her man,
Diana Ross's son.
Diana Ross's son.
Evan Ross.
Evan Ross. Yes. Thank you. And just people like that. Okay.
Yeah.
Where
so,
the fuck you at?
Speaking of reality TV, we have a possible PR stunt relationship.
Bennifer.
Very a la Bennifer. Giving very much Bennifer vibes. Chrishell and Jason.
Oh, Coca-Cola.
But sources, and by sources I mean account that I follow got a blind. And not from Dumois, because Miss Dumois likes to give us a lot. But this was actually from Bravo and Cocktails, one of our favorite Bravo accounts.
I do like Bravo and Cocktails.
Yeah. They said So they, this person was a part of the Selling Sunset crew, saying that Jason and Chrishell
were... Christine Quinn?
I don't know.
Okay, go ahead. Because Christine Quinn, she seems like she would do it like this because she hates Chrishell. But go ahead.
Jason and Chrishell were hooking up even before her divorce was filed by Justin. Justin was always out of town filming. And while they were filming Selling Sunset, a season three, they kept it on and off. And some crew and cast members knew, but just like turned a blind eye.
I'm telling you, I feel like Christine Quinn did this because she has cheap beef with Chrishell. They never liked each other. And if you watch the show, she's always like, but she's fab. She, the way she, I like her, the way she carries herself. She's just those villains that you like to, that you like to love. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Maybe she told the crew like, hey, go ahead and tell people. I don't give a fuck. This is a show that I intend to watch at some point. Just haven't gotten around to it.
So first of all, I just want to say something. I really have a crush on Justin Hartley.
He's so fucking hot. Come on. He
is. Like, it's so frustrating, huh? His hotness is just like... And I just wanted to say that.
No, I agree.
Chrishell, she was also rumored to be dating one of the guys from Dancing with the Stars, no? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I just think it's so weird. Is she dating Jason or Brett Oppenheim?
Jason.
Like, I can already see a play it on the show because Selling Sunset is just so scripted. And
exactly, that's why it's giving me very PR, very Bennifer.
I can just see like the vid, like the camera, like zooming in on her while she's on her laptop, and then zooming in on him, and them looking at each other, and just like people like talking about it. And then Jason used to date Mary, but now Mary is dating Romaine.
Yeah, they actually said something, so now they could stop asking about Jason and Mary.
Did they do this one?
Dun, 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 dun. What would it be? Am I dating Mary? No, I'm with Chrishell.
Yeah, so Jason Oppenheim was dating Mary. Then Mary got married to Roman. Roman doesn't speak English. And so now maybe Roman will feel good that he'll feel gooch that Chrishell. That Chrishell. I just don't see Chrishell dating just Jason. Like, why now?
Me either. Because for ratings, I don't know.
And how is that going to work out? Like, this job won't be like as fair, right? Because like they're all trying to get these deals for their house.
Yeah, dude, if you're dating the broker, you're going to get everything. Like, it's just how it is. It's going to play favorites.
But also Jason Oppenheim is really, really rich.
Yeah.
So Chrishell's looking at the money aspect of it. There's something about Chrishell that I also feel like is a little bit fake.
Oh, 100p. So you fake. Know?
Like, even her, while she was on Dancing with the Stars, remember I used to tell you, like, I just, there was something like, she was like, like, she's kind of like a dead fly. And I don't know, that doesn't, like, translate well in English, but almost como muerta.
Yeah, it doesn't, but I think you adding the, like, literally, like, fly noises.
I get dead fly vibes from her.
I love dead fly vibes.
And I agree with you. I think it is a PR stunt. Mm-hmm. So I don't, there's something, I mean, obviously season four is around the corner and that's why this is coming, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Exactly. And speaking of television shows that are coming up, And Just Like That updates. And if you don't know, And Just Like That is the sequel to Sex and the City. Mm-hmm. Did you start? Sorry. It's okay. It's fine. It's like a huge assignment. Mm-hmm. And if you're just not ready for it, just hold off until
you my play. You know what came out today?
Outer Banks. No. Oh, I did. They were talking about it on Sorry We're Stoned. They were saying Outer Banks is a new season. Mm-hmm.
But you know what I was thinking about Outer Banks? I wonder if it's going to be as good as we thought it was.
As gooch
as we thought it was during the, because Outer Banks came out in the peak of Cornova. So we had nothing to do. And it was like Tiger Heat, Outer Banks, Chew What to Handle, Love is Blind. That's all we were doing. So I'm thinking now that we're like free out, like getting vodka tonics.
More seasons of like more shows. Like everyone's kind of like was able to film.
Yeah. Like I'm wondering if I'll still have that same love for Outer. No, I will. It was good. But
you spoke nothing but good things about it. Yeah. So
I'll be watching it.
So we're, you know, getting more updates on IG and stuff about And Just Like That. But this week, people were shocked.
Shooketh.
Like quivering because...
Pinching their buttholes.
Carrie Bradshaw was seen wearing a dress from Forever 21. And if you know the show, you know that it's like designed, like they push designers. Like you would never think that Miss Bradshaw would be wearing something from Forever 21. That was just like unheard of. Like Forever 21 didn't even exist on the fucking show. If it wasn't Gucci, it wasn't Gucci, you know?
Did you just call her Miss Bradshaw?
Yeah.
Okay, Miss Bradshaw would never.
So people are just like saying that this is because Patricia Fields, who did like the costume design for the show from the beginning to end, is no longer working with the show because she's working on Emily in Paris. And that's, yeah, that's why the clothes is so fucking good on that show. It's
Emily in Paris is currently filming.
Emily in Paris. Yeah. So the fact that she's wearing a dress from Forever 21 is just shocked.
How did they know it was from Forever 21?
Because some people literally have nothing else to do except like do deep dives on like what people are wearing, literally. And because Sex and the City is filmed like on location in New York City, like you can just be walking by and see them film. So you could just like snap pictures.
Miss Bradshaw, I cannot never not call her now that Miss Bradshaw is like 60. Why is she wearing Forever 21?
Because in her heart, she's no. God, I stopped myself because it was just awful. Good. I don't know, because I mean, to a certain extent, like she's just got to wear what the costume designer is going to give her, you know?
Yeah.
So I don't know what the fuck they're doing. I could see if it was like an independent designer, but Forever 21, you know, there's this whole movement of trying to like kill fast fashion because it's terrible for the environment. And then just like the working conditions for people who work in those factories are atrocious.
On factory to you.
So I'm just shocked that like they're even having Forever 21 on such an iconic show, because Forever 21 is just everything that fashion isn't.
Yeah, I agree. But I have a confession to make, because I am what? Transparent. My friend, I won't say his name, was wearing Forever 21 shorts the other day, and it's like some shows about like this Lucha Libre thing, and I want those shorts. And
oh no, I
was like, where did you get your shorts from? He's like, Forever 21. I was like, I want
them. No. I still buy things here and there from Forever 21. But when you have a show like Sex and the City, where it was like Manolo's, Gucci, Louis Vuitton, everything. You just keep pushing Tom Ford.
I know. This is the second time I pushed Tom Ford
today. Don't you forget it.
But isn't Tom Ford really going to be in House of Gucci?
I don't know. I think he is.
I think he's going to be in it. I mean, it would make sense. Not like one of a big role, but he's going to be in it.
Well, it makes sense. He designed for, that was Dior.
You were like, I'm Gucci.
So it's just shocking. Also, like, I think it sucks that like they could be promoting like independent designers, up and coming designers, and they throw a Forever 21 dress on her. Just make it make sense.
Make it make sense.
And lastly, because Tanya's go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say, I feel as though Miss Bradshaw, if she wants to wear Forever 21, let her wear Forever 21.
Okay, I'm gonna see what you think about that after you're like in season 3 or 4 of Sex and the City, and then you let me know.
No, you're right. I have no horse in this race. I haven't even watched Sex and the City. I've only watched the movie. So you know what? Shut me up.
Enough. Enough. Lastly, I just wanted to say that The Prince is now on HBO Max. If you don't know, creator Gary Jannetty has been making funny memes about Prince George for years now, and he ended up developing an adult cartoon show for HBO Max called The Prince. Some of the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills are guest stars.
Yeah, Kyle DeReed, Erica. But are they actually like, they went and recorded their voices, right?
Correct. Yeah.
So we got DeReed, Kyle, Erica, Garcelle, and yes, the one and only Teddy Mellencamp.
Hi, I'm Teddy.
You did
so good. So I plan on watching this. As you know, I'm not huge on adult cartoons, but this is one that I just love it. I love his humor.
Except King of the Hill, you love that one. I couldn't even say it with a serious face.
He's so fucking trashy.
So imagine you watching King of the Hill.
Like, or American Dad.
I don't. I mean, I remember we talked about this before, Tanya, about how it's okay if guys do it, just not girls.
Yeah. And I mean, I'll watch a Family Guy here and there, but
I watch Family Guy. I feel like
Family Guy is the exception for everyone.
I watch South Park sometimes. Sorry. Mm-hmm.
I watched South Park in elementary school because all the cool kids were doing it. And I know I wasn't supposed to.
And I had a Kenny Alcancia.
Who killed Kenny?
My mom bought it for me. She did not know what South Park was about. I asked her to buy it to me at Spencer's.
I thought you were going to say it was from the border. Because you know how the border, they have alcancias of every single character.
But my mom would not. I would not ask for that.
And just like that.
But I bought it at the Spencer's in Horton Plaza. Another throwback. Two throwbacks in one sentence. Spencer's, R.I.P. Horton Plaza.
R.I.P.
I have to tell you something, though. Speaking of, what's the show called again that we're going to watch? You were just speaking of your story. I'm sorry. The Prince.
The Prince.
Also on HBO Max, I want everyone, all the Shishinators, to start watching The White Lotus, because me and Tanya are going to start recapping it. It's star-studded. Just look at it.
Star.
And Molly Shannon's on it. That's what you need to know. All of the podcasts that I've been listening to, I've been recapping it, like Two Girls, The Morning Toast, Jackie Schimmel. Everyone's watching it. Me and Tanya are hopping on that boat. There's only 3 episodes left, which means that Tanya's going to be ahead of me in no time.
That's so true. You have to start a show weeks before me, if not months.
If not months, really, though.
You literally told me about Love is Blind after The Altar, and I'm like, cool. I'm like, I'm done.
I was like, wait. But yeah, I'm excited to watch The Prince. I want to see what it's all about.
Me too.
And I think that was it, right?
That was it. You got your 5 servings of Tanya's tea.
Well, without further ado, it's time for everyone's favorite segment.
I'm stopped. Bravo, bravo, bravo. I am not doing this, you guys.
And as per usual, for those in the back.
Bravo, bravo, bravo. I am not doing this, you guys.
Bravo news. You got any?
Nicki Minaj is campaigning to host the reunion of Real Housewives of Potomac. And Joe, the publicist, slid into her DMs and said, Andy Cohen said he would gladly give up his seat to have you host the Potomac reunion. It tapes around October. It would be really fucking funny. And he's going to get more details. And Nicki Minaj is on board. The cast of Potomac is on board. Bravo stands are on board. Potomac stands are on board. And like you said, this is going to give Potomac the justice it finally deserves after 5 fucking seasons.
Potomac for life.
I'ma be Potomac for life.
The Real Houses of Potomac is probably our favorite franchise of Housewives right now for me and Tanya. Obviously, before Potomac started, we had Jersey as our favorite, but Jersey's like out right now because they're on. I think they actually just wrapped up filming for New Jersey. I heard.
Yeah, makes sense because they've been filming for a while now.
Yeah. So Potomac, the fact that Nicki Minaj watches it, it gives me the validation that I need. And you know that there's some people out there, Tanya, like some Bravo people that don't watch Potomac?
If you don't watch Potomac at this point, you cannot call yourself a Bravo stan.
No,
I'm sorry.
There's no way.
I'm sorry.
There is no way. I'm excited. I would like to see Nicki Minaj host Potomac. She did say something like she wants to like come for Candace. Did you see that?
I didn't.
Not in a bad way. She wasn't shading Candace, but she's like, someone said, because you know how Candace has a new song?
Yes. Okay. Yes. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. Candace has a new song. And you know, Candace is actually a really good singer. I'm going to give her that.
Yeah. It's just that she throws it in people's faces and they're just like, okay, enough.
Yes. And the Watch What Happens Live people said we need a feature song with Nicki and whatever. And Nicki's like, what's that? She's like, it's Candace's song. And she's like, oh yeah. She's like, that song's cute. I like it, but I need to ask some questions to Sissy.
Yes, I did see that. I love and as I've said before, I went back and I've been watching Potomac on season 3. I just love that she walks in a room, she goes, hello.
Yeah. Especially when they went to
they
went on their trip. Where was their trip at?
And season 3 was Paris.
They were in Paris and she was just singing in every single like chops.
Joyous anniversary. Joyous anniversary. So it was Monique's birthday in Paris, so she's singing in French.
You know, Candace was on Watch What Happens Live with Nima. It was both of them together.
Oh, and I didn't know, because I really haven't been watching.
Well, Bravo shoves it to me. I don't have no choice. And she was being so funny.
I've always liked her.
Yeah, me too. We've always talked about how we secretly like Candace. Like, yeah. We've never had a problem with
her. I don't think she has a problem. Like, if you bring up my mother in my mother's house, I'm going to put a knife in your fucking face.
And yes, she's bratty, but that's just, you can't take her too seriously. You know what I mean?
I think that's what it is. People take things too fucking seriously. But at that point, you can't enjoy the show. Why are you watching the show? You're going to suffer.
If I took these shows too seriously, I wouldn't watch anything. I'd be pissed the whole time. Exactly. You have to take it for what it is. And Candace is just like,
she's such good TV.
Yeah. But Nicki Minaj hosting the reunion, that's great. And it's also going to bring a lot of non-Bravo watchers to Bravo. Like, Nicki Minaj, lest we not forget, she has a huge following.
Yeah,
she
all the Barbs huge, are going to watch just all the because Barbs, of her.
Yep, and she even told the Barbs to tune in and binge this season.
And they said, please don't bug me about an album, though. This is not it. This is not what we're focusing on.
So that would be the first. It would be going down in history, you know? Yeah.
So something to look forward to.
Mm-hmm. Another Bravo news. I really don't have anything else in Bravo news.
Yeah, I feel like it's just like updates on things that we're just tired of talking about.
Oh, well, Rihanna went and stood up for Leah.
Oh, yeah. Because and showed that she does wear Married to the Mom.
Mm-hmm. And I'm like, Rihanna, you're on the wrong side of history, mama. Let's just get into the recap. Let's start with Real Housewives of New York City. What were your thoughts?
I have a confession.
You didn't watch?
No, because last week's didn't, it recorded funny. So mm-hmm. I watched last week's, this week's, and because of Big Brother, I just didn't get around to watching it. But I don't feel like I missed much from what I've seen.
And you're like, I'ma be Potomac for life. I'll just give you a quick synopsis of what happened.
Also because we weren't really covering it, so I didn't feel the pressure.
Yeah, I'll give you a quick synopsis. It's not giving you spoilers because it's not like a competition show. Luann is singing. She wants to put a Christmas song out, and she wants Ramona, Sonia, Ebony, and Leah to sing a part of the song. So the girls are coming in to sing like just literally one line of the song, and Leah's upset because she wants to know the logistics of the song. She wants to know if Leah has to sign some papers, if the song gets sued by any chance, if she's going to be responsible for it. She wants to know if the song makes it good and if it makes it big, and if it makes like billions of dollars and it becomes a hit, will Leah get a cut of that? And it was just to the point where the way Leah was going about it was like, enough!
In the words of Taylor Armstrong.
She was being so insufferable. Then it's also Ramona and Sonia's birthday. So Luann plans her a birthday at a rooftop at, not sure where, I think it was a restaurant. Nice restaurant, very high.
Oh, rooftop. Can you believe it, girls?
A rooftop. And it was obviously during Cornova, so not everyone was there except like the main boys, that guy that Ramona was from last season, that he's younger. They were secretly fucking. I forget his name. The nude guy's back. Yes, the nude guy from the Hamptons.
Oh my God, they loved him. Like, he literally stayed for a kiki.
A kiki. He came back. He was at the party. And Bershawn was there. Ramona is going to have, I'm sorry, Ebony is going to have next week a party. I don't think it's going to be next week on the show, but she said she's going to have a party next week of a, oh my God. It's like when Jewish people get together, they have a Shabbat.
A Shabbat,
but she's calling it a Black Shabbat. And then Ramona's like, why does it have to be a Black Shabbat? Why can't it just be dinner? She's like, no, it's going to be a Black Shabbat because
Ebony's Jewish. Black.
and she's like, and because some of my Black friends that I went with, that we went to Israel together, and you know, they're gonna be there, and it's just a Black Shabbat. Why can't it just be dinner? And it's like, Ramona, I'm just like, just stop. Just let things be.
She just exactly, that's her own fucking fault that she just can't be like, mm-hmm.
She should just mm-hmm. And then Bershawn was standing there, and Ebony's like, yeah, I'm sorry, but I can't invite you. And Bershawn's like, why? She's like, it's because of COVID, and it's because I'm only inviting my Black friends that went to Israel and you didn't, which I thought that was really fucked up.
But if Bershawn is kind of part of the cast now.
Why yeah.
Like, if you're inviting the rest of the cast members, why wouldn't you invite Brashan? That makes no sense.
Yeah, but Brashan said in her confessional, she's like, it's okay, sis. I don't want to go to that. I remember your last party in Harlem. I would not feel like getting taught.
Okay, Brashan.
And then Leah, once again, poking the bear. She's in charge of the cake, and she brings Ramona a penis cake.
I saw that in the commercials.
And it's like, girl, you know she doesn't like it. But of course, Ramona, she didn't fall for it. Good job, Ramona. She just took it as best as she could, and she blew the candle, and she pretended to lick the penis. She was like, mm-hmm. Which was a visual that I didn't want to see. Definitely a visual that I didn't want to see. And then Leah obviously brings back the fact of the song, that she's like, Luann, and Luann does not like getting confronted. Luann kind of gets back at her. She's like, don't do it, girl. Don't do it with me. And she's like, I can do whatever I want.
Oh, Leah.
And then Ramona's like, yeah, I don't know what she's like. I'm sorry. I would even wear your brand if you wanted to. You don't have to pay me, because it seems like Leah wants money. That's what it, I got the vibe from it. She wants money off this song. And if you remember when Luann did Chèque la vie.
Wow. C'est bon.
Alex McCord, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, no, Kelly Benzemo and Jill Zarin. They were went with video. Her to Atlantic City. They didn't ask for any money. They were just like.
C'est bon.
But Leah, she's just being thirsty for it. So then that's when Leah says, oh my God, you're not my demographic, Ramona. I don't need you to wear my stuff. Rihanna wears my stuff. And that's when Rihanna chimed in. And I was like, kind of like, Rihanna, no. If you have Leah McSweeney's back, I can't. I really don't like this woman, Tanya. It's getting really bad.
I know. I'm sorry to this woman.
And then the next episode on next time on The Real House of New York, it seems like they're starting the music video for Luann's Christmas song, and there's some cheap drama.
Yes.
Because she has them all there. And then we also saw this episode that Ebony's still going, having her storyline of looking for her sisters, which I'm like, this is so Melissa Gorga adjacent.
Why?
And Sonia was just being Sonia. She was just drunk. She was just drunk at her party. And then Ramona went home with one of the guys. She's like, let me give you my address.
Oh, yeah. I saw something like Ramona has been in the game for years and still forgets she's mic'd.
But other than that, it wasn't a bad episode. It was just...
I was listening to the Crappens recap, and I agree that it's kind of starting to get going. Like, I mean, I know it's been a while and it's been a slow season, but these past few episodes have been a lot more entertaining than the beginning of the season.
We just need that cast shakeup. Let's get rid of Leah, keep Ebony, bring Dorinda, and bring two new girls, and we're good.
And keep Brashan.
Yeah, she can say I like her. And to end things with Real Houses of Potomac.
I was like, what happened? The spa party.
Yeah, the spa party, Ashley Darby spa party. And it looks like Wendy and Mia get into it again. They're like, bing, bing.
I'm so tired. Like, I don't.
Of when,
like,
Zen? Zen when?
Yeah, I just like, I don't understand what her pedo is.
It's the second season syndrome. It's the second season syndrome. We all.
Her and Leah are just like.
And Bronwyn Wyndham Burke had it bad, but she had to
leave. Oh, yeah. I don't know if Wendy will leave, but she needs to like fucking skirt because she's getting obnoxious. And I never saw that for Wendy.
No, I never saw it either for her either. And like I said, I don't hate Wendy. I still like her, but I'm just confused on why she's trying to be like a Martha Stewart when she praised last season so much about her degrees and being a commentator and all this stuff. I'm sorry, but it doesn't match up. You wanting to be like a cheap influencer decor lady when you have 3 degrees and you're a commenter.
Yeah. Commentator. Robin Dixon said it. And even Karen was like, okay, so what's your business plan? Because as we know, Karen is a businesswoman.
Business. Manila Folder.
She's got La Dame fragrance, La Dame wigs. And okay, so I understand. Okay, you made a candle. Okay. But she wants to make bed sheets, pillows. Like, I'm sorry. Craig Canover has that. We don't need that.
Unless she teams up with Craig and she sells her things and sewing down south.
Wendy Osifo for sewing down south would be brilliant.
They should just have a Bravo store.
Actually, when they had BravoCon, I saw that like everyone that had a business had their merch there, which is kind of funny.
Including Vicky Gumbleton's insurance.
She had Mike Wolf, her son, like, hey, could I sign you up for some insurance?
Why did you give him that voice?
Because I feel like he kind of sounds like this.
You kind of made me feel like what that voice. I thought of the secretary from Monsters, Inc.
I am watching you, Wazowski. Mike Wazowski. Always watching.
Mike Wazowski.
Mike Wazowski.
Yeah, so Wendy Osefo, I'm not sure what's going on, Mama, but I liked you with your 3 degrees and you're being a commentator of what's going on in the Wawa. And
it's the BBL. It fucking fucked with her.
But Mia's not taking it, which I like. I really like Mia.
I like her too. And just side note, when like at her house, when they had that wall of wine, I was like, whoa.
Mm-hmm. And she's just not afraid to speak her truths. Like, she's like, yeah, I was a stripper. Well, apparently she wasn't a stripper. She worked at a gentleman's club where they just wanted to interact with her and pay for her time. And then Giselle's like an escort.
That's also what she made it sound like.
Yeah, basically, right? I was like, that's an escort, like what you're doing. Giselle, why did Giselle leave her own party that she planned for Ashley early?
Because she did not want to be around Karen. Remember, she said, like, I'm not inviting Karen. And Ashley was like, well, it's for me and I want Karen there. She was like, fine. I just think she didn't want to be in the same room with her.
And what do you think about the new friend of?
I like her.
I forget her name.
Shit, what was her name?
It's really hard. You're not gonna, if you didn't remember the competition, the Big Brother competition, how are you supposed to remember this?
God damn it.
It's okay. We're not going to. We can't remember things. This is so hard. This is why we need to take notes.
But I feel like if I take notes, I'm not really enjoying the show.
Yeah, I know what you mean. It becomes like a chore. But it's because I don't know why I have such a hard time remembering things. It's really, I'm concerned.
Because we consume so much content, it's impossible to remember everything.
That's so true. There's so much consumed in our heads, right? Like, and not only that, but consuming stuff from like our actual jobs.
Yeah, this is just like, I feel like aside from like we're knowledgeable in our careers and then just like facts of life and then fucking the insane amount of content that we consume.
Like imagine the inside of our heads. It's like so much shit in there.
It is literally like in my head I have like behavior analysis, data, graphs, mention it all.
And I have, I'm Gooch.
I'm Gooch. You're like, the specimen has now been left alone. I'm Gooch.
Yes. Specimens and Gooch.
Specimen is Gooch.
But you know what's really going to bug me? That I still want to remember that Big Brother competition. And I'm going to remember when we're done filming.
Remember when you remember.
And then I'm going to text it to you because it's really bugging me that I can't remember that fucking name of that competition. You know,
you look like up right the competition. Here. I'm going to look up. Robin's friend in Potomac. You figure out Asifa. The competition. No, that was from Shaw's.
But it's something with an A, right?
Probably.
Okay, well, anyways, the new friend of, she really, like, if you listen to the Ronnie, the Crappins recap, he's like, she went in, got up, punched in her card, and clocked in when she told Karen, I heard you drink a lot.
She's like, this is your assignment. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, Karen.
Yeah, she just like went in for Karen, and Karen's like,
I do the fireball. Oh, because, well, Karen was like, we're gonna do the shots of the fireball.
Mm-hmm. Well, because she wants to do shots of fireball with Ashley Dardar. It looks like the baby will be born next week, next episode.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Another baby Dean. Wow, wow. Oh, wow, wow. And the Robin Dixon of it all. She's just in bed. She doesn't want to get out of bed and she doesn't want to wake up her kids. How about her kids just learn to wake up? Why do we need to wake up the kids?
I couldn't agree more. They're old enough now.
Yeah. Like, wake up on your own, broski. And yes, I did just say broski.
A scala.
We got it, dude. A scala. Yeah, she's a new friend of. I'm here for her. She's ready to play.
And that's why Potomac is.
That's why Nicki Minaj wants to host the reunion.
Because they've brought it since day one.
And if Nicki Minaj wants to host the reunion, then you give it to her.
And that's what's going to happen. And I couldn't be more excited. So we got House of Gooch. We've got Nicki Minaj, Potomac. What more can you ask for?
No, House of Gooch and Nicki Minaj. The two things that are just bringing so much joy into my life.
That and you rolling around in your fresh sheets.
Oh, my fresh sheets. I'm just looking at them. Candace Dillard Bassett, though, on this episode, her talk with Karen, it seemed like her and Karen are just, I like that they had the conversation because I feel like they care about each other. I really do feel that Karen cares about her.
I agree, yeah.
But I just feel like they both can't get what they want from each other. Like, mm-hmm. Candace is kind of spratty and she's just kind of making it seem like Karen apologized for not having my back 100% exactly. And not hating Monique. And Karen's like, I was so hurt by this, which is Karen, you're not hurt by this. This has nothing to do with you. So,
your hair wasn't pulled, girl. Yeah. I don't know what you're talking about.
So I saw both of them and I feel like they might become friends. It seems like they're gooch.
I think so too. I mean, Candace literally said that Karen was the second most important woman in her life next to her mom. Like not even her sister, Karen Huger.
Oh yeah, I forgot about Candace's sister. Well, yeah. So next episode's going to be a gooch one because they get in another fight, right? It seems like Wendy Osefo and Mia get in another argument next episode. So this is what the whole scene is going to be, right? Mia versus Wendy.
Yeah, but it just doesn't make sense. So it can get old fast. Luckily, we have everyone else doing their job.
Mm-hmm. That's true. And also just wanted to say one more thing about Below Deck Med. If you watch Below Deck Med this week, wow. Bethany, wow. The whole hour of the show, like there was things happening that should have been such a big deal and they weren't just because of other bigger things happening. The chef quit. The chef left. He got drunk. He left in the middle of the night, packed his knives and left. Then they get back in the jacuzzi, all the drama. Lexi's a monster, like a legit monster. Like I've never seen someone more monstery than her. And it was just, wow, Bethany, wow. Below Deck Med, it's giving it to you. That's all I'm going to say.
And what more could you ask for? Below Deck Med is actually super popular. And I started watching some of it on Peacock. So maybe I'll catch up to you soon.
You're like, I want to see your peacock.
Peacock. Your peacock. Cock. Yeah, peacock. Cock. Yeah, peacock. Cock. And honestly, this is like, I feel like the best way to segment out of this episode.
This is the best way. Once we peacock out of here. Chef's kiss. So remember, rate, review, subscribe. Thanks for listening. Thanks for being with me and Tanya in these gooch moments. And you guys are with us in the gooch and in the bad.
Follow me on all accounts, Tanya31, specifically my OnlyFans is Tanya69. So
ooh, Coca-Cola.
Very original.
Me, yeah, so original. And follow me at Odrasir_47McGuire. That's where I give the premium content that you need to know on Twitter, Insta, Snappy, and all those other, you know, websites you kids are doing.
Without further ado,
let's get into it. Oh yeah. Bye.